In 1902, a 12-year-old girl was killed by a young man who tried to assault her. She screamed at him to stop because it was a sin, and he risked going to hell. But in his anger over not getting what he wanted, he stabbed her again and again, a total of 14 times. Mortally wounded, she lingered in pain until the next day when, before she died, she forgave him. Hello, I'm Father James Kubicki, and that young girl is the saint whom we honor today, Maria Goretti. A little known fact in this story is that as a youth, her murderer, named Alessandro, used to spend hours feeding his imagination with suggestive pictures and sexual stories. By today's standards, these were probably pretty mild, but these images worked their way into Alessandro's imagination nonetheless, and led him to see Maria as an object for his fantasy and pleasure. Saint Maria Goretti was a martyr for chastity and is considered a patron saint for young people and all those fighting pornography. Though we have a terrible environmental crisis, the oil spill in the Gulf, we should think about the environmental crisis that pornography poses. Here's how Archbishop Chaput of Denver spoke about it a few years back. Very few people want to name the biggest single environmental crisis we face, a multi-billion dollar pornography industry that pours garbage into our homes every day through the web and other media. Citizens need to stop the pornography industry because it poisons the human heart, imagination, and soul, just as steel mills once poisoned our air and water, only worse. Pornography is poison. It should be controlled like any other toxic waste. And don't be fooled. This isn't censorship. It's a matter of public health and common sense.